The Miami Dolphins have their coach and general manager in place, and that shouldn't change with the outcome of Sunday's game, but they don't deserve new contracts. There have been some who believe that Miami, specifically Stephen Ross, should extend Brian Flores now. Flores will enter the fourth year of the five-year deal in 2022. Chris Grier doesn't get as much fan love when it comes to contracts. With a win on Sunday, the Dolphins and Flores will have put together back-to-back winning seasons for the first time since the 2002 and 2003 seasons when the Dolphins went 9-7 and 10-6. 2003 ended a run of seven seasons above. In 2013 and 2014, the Dolphins finished 8-8. For those hoping to see a coaching change, don't. Giving up this early, 3 years into a contract, is exactly what the Dolphins' problems tend to be. That being said, there are reasons to want to see one or both of them go. Brian Flores' inability to land quality assistant coaches is a problem, especially on offense where it seems no one has an idea of what is going on. The offense has been consistently bad since he arrived and there has been little improvement. Tua Tagovailoa should be the team's franchise quarterback, but lack of quality coaching is not giving him the direction that he needs and that could lead to his departure. The entire Deshaun Watson ordeal is not going to go away anytime soon, and if the Dolphins do make that trade, without a change in the offensive coaching, Watson isn't going to save their jobs. You can't discount the players that Grier has brought into the organization. Jalen Waddle, Jalen Phillips, Javon Holland all became major players on the roster in their rookie seasons. They should continue to improve. Free agency has been a problem for Grier and Flores, and that needs to change immediately. If the Dolphins fail to make the playoffs next year or find themselves scrapping at the end of the year for other teams to lose so they have a shot, then we can discuss a change, but honestly, if a change is made with Flores and Grier, there might also need to be a change with Ross as well. Important season finale for Tua. In his final weekly media session of the 2021 NFL season, Miami Dolphins quarterback Tua Tagovailoa was asked to look ahead a bit, more specifically whether he wondered whether he was anticipating more trade rumors regarding a potential replacement or him. "No, and I'm not worried about that," Tagovailoa said. "If it comes up, it comes up. If it doesn't, it doesn't." Well, Tagovailoa better be ready for those rumors because they're coming, and they might not even be limited to Deshaun Watson. There is one way Tua could end all that talk, maybe, and that's with a lights-out performance against the New England Patriots in the season finale at Hard Rock Stadium on Sunday. But looking at Tua's first two seasons in the NFL, he just hasn't had that kind of outing against a quality opponent, which is partly why the trade speculation involving Watson surfaced in 2021 and likely will pop up again this offseason. Tua and the numbers. For those not buying the premise, the numbers back up the point. The game against New England on Sunday will mark the eighth time that Tagovailoa has started against a team that did or will finish the season with a winning record. His record in those first seven such games, since some of his supporters so often like to bring up his one-loss record, is 2-5, with a victory against the Rams in 2020 and against the Patriots in the opener in 2021, and losses against Kansas City and Buffalo in 2020 and against the Bills twice and Tennessee in 2021. Worse, Tua's passer rating in those seven games is 69.4. In those seven games, he has five touchdown passes and seven interceptions. His best passer rating in any of those seven games was the 83.3 he posted in the 33-27 loss against Kansas City in December 2020, when he had 150 passing yards and a touchdown in the fourth quarter after the Chiefs led 30-10. When it comes to comparing Tua numbers to those of other NFL quarterbacks, he did lead the league in completion percentage for several weeks but dropped to 7th after his 18-for-38 outing at Tennessee. Tua isn't higher than 18th in the NFL in any other statistical passing category and stands 19th in passer rating at 89.8. The case for Tua continuing to be the starting quarterback. There certainly are some arguments to be made in favor of moving forward with Tua as the starting quarterback, starting with the fact he's only been in the NFL for two seasons and he did have his 2021 season interrupted by his ribs and finger injuries, though that also plays into the durability concerns about him. There's also the fact that the Dolphins did invest the fifth overall pick on him just two drafts ago. And then there's the issue of the personnel around him on offense, namely a shaky offensive line and a poor running game. But while there is some merit to that, some of that also is massively overstated. For one, while some would have you believe the Dolphins' offensive line is the worst to ever see a field in the NFL and Tua is under constant pressure, just know that Pro Football Advanced Stats has him at 23rd. When it comes to percentage of times pressure per dropback at 21.5%. Yes, Tua gets rid of the ball quickly, which comes with the abundance of short passes, But let's also not pretend as though Tua is constantly running for his life. And just check out the tape of the Tennessee game if you don't believe that. Besides, isn't an elite quarterback supposed to make everybody else on offense better? Can we really say that Tua has done that so far? The plain truth is that Tua has not been elite so far or anywhere near a franchise quarterback, which is obviously what the Dolphins want. So should the Dolphins move forward with him or look for somebody else? Tua sure could make that decision easier for the team, if it's not already made one way or the other, if he can finish out the season with a bang. Remember after the trade deadline passed back in early November and it became official that Tua would be the starting quarterback for the remainder of this season? How those remaining games were viewed as an audition for Tua. That audition is almost over. It would help Tua's case to leave a positive final impression.